And welcome back to MLB The Show 17. No, I'm sorry, I'm new to the show. I know I've only done like three of the Odell series. But right now, I'm going to try out a new player. He's going to be a starting pitcher, righty. And if you didn't see below the title, we're going to have Eli Manning if he went to be a starting pitcher. We're going to have a four-seam fastball. We're going to have a cutter. And you know what else we're going to have? We're going to have a... I'm going to pick like a one I don't even know what it is. Okay. I don't know what a circle change is, so we're going to pick a circle change. He is going to have a lot of control. Feeling his brake and his control. His brake control, velocity can go a little bit, yeah. Where's Eli? Where is Eli Manning from?
Eli Manning's birthplace is New Orleans, Louisiana.
Oh god, where's Louisiana? I'm just gonna say Central. Let's just get a picture of Eli Manning up in my phone. Here we go. Okay, let's just take a look. Okay. I have a picture of him based off of. General. Name. Eli. Oh, no. Eli. Manning. Okay, first name. Don't even call me Eli. Eli, they're gonna have Manning. I don't think they're gonna have Manning. So the D, G, H, J, K, L. Manning, oh, they actually did okay. Number 10. Rohan Wright, birthplace, so just in Louisiana. Look at Louisiana. Alright, that's good. Appearance, skin tone, he's a little bit like. You can't say that, dark. He's like that. How tall is he? How tall is Eli Manning? How much does Eli Manning weigh?
I could be off by a little, but I think Eli Manning weighs 218 pounds.
218 buck neck. His shoulders are actually pretty big, so that's like wide and those a little bit. It's like around there. His arms are definitely not that big. Just like his arms like around there. His shoulders like, yeah, I'd say shoulders like around there. They're like a little bit smaller. I'd say like something around there. That's pretty good for the body. Head shape. This is a photo. You gotta see what kind of head shape he has. No, he's definitely not Asian. He's got a pretty big nose. I think there was one that kinda looked like him. It was this one. Nah, that face isn't wide enough, felt like. That one kinda looks like it, if I was to fix the eyebrows a little bit. Yeah, we'll go with that one. Hairstyle. Like, I don't think they're gonna have his hairstyle. That's too long. That's too long. I think this is actually the closest we're gonna get to this hairstyle. Actually, I think that is, but it's like he doesn't have that, like the line in it. No. Close. Nah, I think this is the closest we're gonna get. Well, either one of these two. I don't know which one we're gonna get. Yeah, we'll go with this one. His hair is pretty light. Maybe a little bit darker. Like around there. Okay. I think he has a little tiny bit of facial hair. Let's just like see. I'm gonna get the stubblest stubble with like a little mustache. That's too much. Only if that can be like a little bit lighter. Like not as much of a stubble. That's kind of like a chinchilla. I know he does, but this is like too much. Yeah. Oh, why does he still have it? No. No, I don't want that any. Alright, we gotta fix those. Our most eye color does he have? Those eyebrows are terrible. I think he's like beige brown. Just like that. Okay, eyebrows. Here we go. Let's get some normal eyebrows. What is this? Get some normal eyebrows. His eyebrows are actually pretty far apart. That's too big. Yeah, but that's pretty good. Nose. He definitely has a big nose. I want to edit his head shape, head scale now, and point now. Forehead, there we go. The forehead is what I was looking for. We need to have that receding hairline of Eli Manning. Here we go. Like around there. Hairline, put that all the way back. Oh my god. No, he has like that. Dome shape, no. That's the back of the head. I need like... What's temple depth? Big nose. Ugh. No, he looks like that. It's not the best, but I think it's like the closest I'm gonna get. His hair's actually a little bit darker than that. There we go. That's like the closest I'm gonna get. Let me actually fix those nose. Right. Okay. That's like the closest I'm gonna get. His actually neck is really long. I realized how long his neck was. His eyebrows are too close. They're like way farther apart in the picture. I'd say like around there. Yeah, we're gonna go with those eyebrows. I know it's nothing like him. Neck size, here we go. He has a long neck. feels like a neck like that, yeah. Okay. Alright, I think that's it. Motions. Like, I don't know how I'm gonna get it. Like, how does he throw a pitch? He's like, that's a good windup for him. I hate that windup. This is like my most hated windup in the whole game. Wait, no, where is it? No, that one. I hate that windup. I need a good windup. You gotta give Eli Manning a good windup. I kinda like that one, yeah. I kinda like that one. Running style. He's just gonna have some generic running. He's never gonna catch. Our batting stance doesn't really matter. I don't think we're ever gonna bat. Actually, no, we might actually bat, so this might matter a little bit. Let's get a good batting stance for Eli. This is if Eli was to choose that MLB over. I'm gonna go with that. And the follow through. I'm gonna go with two hand follow through, I think. I think Eli would have a two hand follow through. Yeah, like that. Practice swing, yeah, that works. Stride. Yeah. Take it. Alright. Home run. Yeah, we can go with that. Okay. Equipment. It's just. Both and a 3/4 sleeve. I don't want to go with it. I don't want any. Yeah, sleeves and tape. Batting gear. Batting gloves, yeah. He's gonna have some batting gloves too, but they're gonna be like just like that. That. A brown bat because of a football. So now a full on brown bat with white gear because of a football. Yeah. But the white is going to be spiral.
Yeah.
That like cross like that. Get some high power. A barrel ring, yes. No pine tuck, yeah. His glove is gonna be brown for a football. Footballs. That's so much shit are brown. Is it dark? Yeah, dark brown. Actually, no, I'm gonna go with the normal brown. Because he would be holding a football. Finger out, yes. I think he looks pretty classy. Looks like he's ready to throw a pitch. Okay, we're good. Let me kill him, Max. Why, they don't have number 10. I didn't have this problem with Odell. Odell got to be able to be 13. Oh my god. Have to be number 11. These players know it's gotta be really annoying.
After a lonely wait, a pitching prospect is called for his turn to take
Eli.
Out.
Here we go.
A coach tries to
set him. He wants to throw a cutter. Well, Eli's got the best cutter in all the league. Look at that. A fastball? Eli's got all the best fastball in the league.
The player knows his whole day comes down to just the next few minutes. Many eyes are on him. All he can do is try to make
him. Look at that cutter. We're throwing the pitch, I don't even know what it is. A circle change. Oh, I like that circle change. Okay. You want fastball? Right there. Good. Beautiful. Is there a fastball? Fastball right there? Amazing fastball. Another one? Fastball right there. Look at that. This is like how I pitch normally, so like, this is how I'm going to be pitching in the game. Is that our fastball? That wasn't a good one. Oh, never mind, it was. I lost to our cutter. We have a pretty nasty cutter. Pretty nasty cutter. Oh, that was not a good cutter. That was not a whatever. That Eli Manning cutter. Like, you can't catch up to it. Alright. The circle change, the pitch I did not even know what it is, which I kinda like. I know there's like pitches that you think I wouldn't know, like a Vulcan chain, but I actually do know what a Vulcan chain is. And also like a slurm. I know all of that. I've tried all of them, I like all of them. The only pitch I never try is a circle change. Which that's why I'm trying it with Eli. I think that was a pretty good pitch up there.
When it's over,
so the scouts come he's number 11. Make personal
contact with a player of
11.
Interest.
11. Continue. What number was Eli in college? If he was 10, then I don't know what number I'm gonna play him as. And Eli was 10 in college.
Promising young baseball talent receives a call from his former high school coach.
Maybe, like, should I use his brother's number?
Seems fit to take on a sports agent. In the aftermath of a scout day, players are anxious to learn what impact
maybe
their
his brother's
performance
number?
May have made. Modern media offers an unprecedented glut of feedback.
Yeah, we'll see if they have his brother's
but
number.
But wisdom would suggest a young athlete focus on what is ahead. What is in his control?
His brother's number was 18. We'll put him as 18. And now they don't even have 18. As I can see in the corner, I have 22. So, I guess Eli's gonna have to be 11. Or we can do his age. But for this game, he's gonna have to be number 22.
So striding in, Adrian Carbajal. It leads things off here
circle
in the bottom
change.
Half of the
circle change right there.
Second baseman.
Adrian
is
his cut on the miss below the knees and it's 1-1.
That's the high inside.
He's ready. Here's the 0-1. High
pop up.
Manning.
We got it.
He's
we
underneath
got it.
This one.
We got it.
One gun.
Eli Manning got it. He's got that brown glove for what a football would be.
Now with the play, Clifford Manzanillo.
He also has a
brown bat. In the windup and
Clifford
the pitch.
Manzanillo.
Sends that one out of play for strike one.
I'm going to go circle change.
Windup and the 0-1. Hit on the ground
it's
out
ground,
to short. Pan moving to his right.
I'm going for a no hitter.
Two down.
I know it's pretty early, but I'm going for a no hitter.
Digging in. Greg Plesser, no one aboard for him, and
Greg
he's gone here in the first.
No one, no strike.
He's off 1-0.
As a starting pitcher.
The windup and a 1-0 pitch.
Hey!
Laid off as it caught the inside corner.
The Odell series, he got drafted by the Seattle Mariners.
A little bit outside.
Which are a decent
Jason
team.
Here with two men out.
And he's Dylan double there. Jumps there we go. Got him chasing with that circle change.
Well, that changeup right there sets up a lot of cutter. Now counts two and two. He can come back in with the fastball. It's going to look
cutter like high three. There
got
we go.
Him looking. And that'll do it. The inning is over. Pretty painless half of the inning all told. Digging
I
in now, Rico Valenzuela will lead things off here in this one-run contest.
Rico
Valenzuela. Back.
Starting pitcher's back. Because I have a closing pitcher one, and because of a closing pitcher, I have
one.
But I think starting pitchers will.
Skied into straightaway
no,
right.
I have to have another sergeant. Okay, good.
In his tracks now, one down. Now with the plate. Boyd Yancey.
Pitcher. That's a random one.
Yancey.
But
the ball hit in the
it
air.
Worked.
Soria in the shallow left. Two down.
Oh,
stepping in.
David
Wilkinson.
Designated hitter.
Rounded up the first baseline. But a foul ball here. 0-1. Wind up and the 0-1. Now a swing and a fly ball.
Is that, catch it, please.
And
still don't have it.
He's caught as he had to go a long way to get there, but he pulls it in right.
Yeah, I don't bat.
Stepping in, Kevin Fall. He'll get us going in the home half of inning number three. Swinging bunt up the mound. Foul ball, however, strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. On the ground to the left side.
Yes.
To his left, Soria.
Oh.
Quick out number one.
I haven't
in now,
anyone ever with my closing pitcher.
First pitch to him.
And that is not going to change
up high for a strike.
Pretty lucky to get away with that one. There's not a situation ever where you want to throw a high change, so I think he'll try to make an adjustment with the next one he throws. I guess he's really trying to best play the fastball in his first at bat, but you really never want to put yourself in an OT count if you could do anything about it.
Couldn't get the bat off his shoulders that time. Alderson becomes out number two this inning. And look out.
He's
got him right in the chest. Fortunately, he's able to stick with it and get the out at first.
Your attention, please.
Oh, they took me out already?
A single run good enough to do it today. 1-0.
I pitched a no-hitter.
Welcome, Palmeiro.
I pitched a no-hitter. Pitched two balls the whole entire game. Had two strikeouts. Not too bad. And I just got like 42 Snapchats. It's the same thing. Okay.
As the draft nears and teams begin to identify prospects for their target, a game of dreams also becomes a game of dollars. May gain an early upper hand in negotiation. This is the game behind the game, and it needs to be played just as hard by those who want to come out on top.
We are never going to back, but still. I don't want to wear elbow guard. Sunglasses. Look at that. Fat grip. I know I have those, but I don't want to wear those right now. We're going back to 10. I kinda actually don't like the glasses. Alright, let's go with another one. So annoying that I can't be number 10, or I can't be number 11. Thank you. next best thing.
Riding into the box, Park, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. And this one will be foul back in among the fans.
Grab the ball. Okay. Low in the side, circle change.
Wind up, and the 0-1. Sent on the ground out in second. Flores has it. Number one. In now, Daryl Covey.
High outside circle change.
Sends that one out of play for strike one.
Low inside cutter.
And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner.
Inside.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Takes a look at a strike over the inside corner.
Frozen with a high fastball there. We'll see if they try to climb the ladder even more on the next pitch.
Don't hit
the other way out to left center. Pruitt will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning.
Oh my God, I almost hit him.
Into the windup and hit.
Send
him Matthews.
One ball.
He's in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0.
That might have been the worst call I've ever seen in this entire game.
That swung on and missed, and we're even at 1-1.
Pretty lucky to get away with that one. There's not a situation ever where you want to throw a high changeup, so I think they'll try to make an adjustment.
That was a flat
dribbler down the line. It's a foul for the second strike.
I don't know what he saw there. Alright,
we're still going to strike him out, because we always strike him out. Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. Two out, nobody
out.
We're
going to get a swing
back with a fastball. Strike three called. The inning is over. So a relatively routine strike.
Yeah, so that's a strike, but rather the pitch wasn't.
Into the box now. Johnny Navarro. He'll lead it off here to begin the second. High in the air out toward shallow right. Has it, and
we
it's
are pitching
out
another no-hitter. Telling you right now.
At the plate, Eduardo
Guardado.
Now it's
over
in the third base dugout. Is that thing near?
Wait. Where did the bat go? Oh my God! This dude. He swings, and he loses the bat. Where does it land? What, is it gonna hit him? It goes right over, where does it go? Where is it? Oh my God. It lands. Okay, this is the perfect angle. Okay, so he swings. Goes all the way over there. And it goes through the stands. And it's that guy in there. That was, might have been the greatest thing I've ever seen in this game.
Pitch on its way. And this is going to be a foul ball.
Every time you go out there to start a game on the mound,
I think that honestly was the greatest thing I've ever seen in this game. And strike three
looks like this is pretty deep into this one.
So it was a strikeout looking there. Eduardo Guardado
sent
packing for route number two in the inning.
No.
And he'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
I can never do good
at the plate. Andreas Vasquez.
The face. That I'm pitching, I can never get little ground balls that come to me.
0-1. Lifted in the air to center field.
No, let's not do something kind of. Okay.
He makes the play. Great catch on the run. Stepping in, Billy Adams.
Not my player's fault.
Open things up here in the third. Had him reaching that time. Strike one.
That is my error.
Got fouled at the plate here, and it's 0-2. Now the pitch. And he got it. Now at the plate, Joaquin Curran.
This guy's face. Strike at the knee. Oh my god. That is the best pace I've ever seen.
Looks like he swung it underwater that time for strike two.
That is the best face I've ever seen. He's the greatest one.
That missed one and two.
Well, he wanted that one, and he probably should have got it.
Where is that out?
His stuff is so good right now.
Honestly, I don't know where that is out.
That's three.
And what? And that's a strike? Strike three call. But the other thing wasn't? Oh, my God.
Riding in once again, William Park. 0-for-1 for him here in this William. One.
It's
swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. Sergeant under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Nothing across. He's
your attention,
Mitch.
Please.
Oh, yeah, let's get, okay, I pitched a
4-2
hitter.
The final score today.
They end up winning. Just about does it. Hitter. Is gonna draft us. What lucky team is gonna get the best player who ever lived? The GOAT. The greatest man who ever lived. Eli Manning. Where's he gonna go? There we go. We have to call him. Or he say where we're gonna be.
Having a trusted advisor
okay.
To take the lead
that.
On such matters is
it?
Right, welcome everyone.
We're in the first round. First round. Rockies?
With the 17th
Astros,
of the first
I'll
round, the Houston Astros select Eli Manning, a starting pitcher from the Central Region.
They select Eli Manning. Houston Astros. I will take that.
Every detail of this conversation and moment. In the days and weeks that follow, teams work to come to terms with the players they have drafted.
Signed the Houston Astros. Eli Manning is on the Houston Astros. And we're going to play a couple games. Well, he's not actually on the Houston Astros, is he? He's on the Hawks.
His team
the
many of
so,
men, was the first
we didn't play we didn't start Eli Manning the first game of the season? What is wrong with you? Who doesn't start Eli Manning the first game of the season? Eli Manning is the greatest pitcher to ever live. He's the only person to ever play football and baseball. Besides, we're just about to come be to
Tebow. And
there was also
stepping
another
in,
guy
who
played
football and baseball.
Now
what
was it? We never turned around. I didn't even check that. We never
turned around.
And Harold, you take a look at our visitors here with the early lead tonight as we play the bottom of the first. It's been a promising start to the new year as they've taken three of the first four contests.
We're something with a more out of it.
Playing on the road.
I am
one on this
yes.
Road trip. They put it together. They continue to keep running like this.
We're first round
run.
Pick.
I like the call
for first round pick
change.
Status
you gotta make
for the Houston
Astros. No, that's right. Those two misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now.
Yes, can't cut me a break.
I like that
go.
Pitch right there. You got two strikes on him. Throw that change up and see if he chases it. That's
my first double strikeout.
Hey, good idea.
And as he punches him out there, he collects his first double A strike.
The glove is brown to represent a football. You're wondering.
But you know his sights are set on a
that's
lot higher than
glove is brown.
Figuring out how to strike out a lot more guys
that
at this
is
level
that is also
as he progresses
brown.
In the minors will be one of the keys for him reaching the big leagues.
Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
And he's
got
three strikeouts.
Not
three strikeouts. Two
strikeouts.
When I said three, I meant we're that time three strikeouts in a row. Because we are going to pitch a no-hitter.
Really the
and we're
going to
get
strike
that
one
team that low cutter and get the swing on it.
0-2 on this hitter.
I got to count 1-2.
Record it quick because he came right after
that's
the hitter.
Like
I don't think that
today.
Changes right now either. He's going to continue to be aggressive to this hitter as well.
Hard hit at third. Oh, look at the sliding scuff. That's off. Go quietly here in this half inning. One inning in the books here. The Hooks are out in front here. 1-0. So digging in now, Edgar Benitez is back in the starting lineup for this one after sitting out last night's game. Sends that one out of play for strike one. into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Tap down the line. That winds up a foul.
It's going to be a foul. High in the circle change.
It swung on and hit. In the alley for route number one.
All right, here's how the visitors are lining up defensively, courtesy of Majestic. I'm focusing on the shortstop. I love the fact he's got a cannon for an arm. He can bobble a ball and still have the ability to throw a guy out. His arm's that strong.
D-Rod! And missed 1-1. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Again, he sends it out of play. He'll try again, 1-2. Another one sent foul.
Well, that's three foul balls in a row. He's definitely battling up there.
Now another 1-2. And this is down at knee level as it's chopped foul at home plate. Here's another 1-2.
Ball.
Just a bit high that time as he misses for a ball.
Seems like he's throwing everything at him, the kitchen sink, and he just fouled him off. So he tried to throw something right there and make him chase, and he didn't. So I don't know where he goes from here.
Hernandez comes on now and makes the catch in shallow center for round number two. Stepping in, Sean Tejada.
Third baseman.
Into the windup and the pitch.
Tejada.
D-Rod.
And he jumps at a changeup, a swing and a miss. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Bowden moves over, makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one. Now to the plate, Henry Garcia. He'll get us going in the home half of inning number three.
Henry,
and this is fouled straight back. The windup and the 0-1. Weak roller right side. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
Well, he went for the big swing and ends up getting a swinging bunt. You couldn't have rolled the ball any better. Starts off the inning. Here we go. We're off and flying.
Very sorry about that.
In now, Chris Mazo. He did not play last night. He'll be back in the starting nine for this one.
Mazo.
And that misses ball one.
That is not a good way.
1-0 pitch. Swing and a little blooper to center. Hernandez comes on now and he has it one down. Scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up.
I still can't believe that.
Swings and misses there, so he's down 0-1. Runners on first with one down. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2.
That looked like he was cheating for that fastball inside right there. Early swing, got out in front of that off-speed pitch.
Bowden has a play. He's got it, and there are two down now. Riding in once again, Terrence Gore. Hey. 0-1 for him here in this one.
Terrence
in for a call, strike one. This is swung on and lifted down the left field line. He'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now. 0-2. Here comes the
off-speed
pitch. Swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. So it's no
run.
Stepping in and ready for another shot.
Leading off the fourth inning, Hawthorne
comes into this at bat. 0-1 in the ballgame. Hernandez is in pursuit. One out.
Good. You've been the best pitcher in the league.
Digging in to try it again. First up, Milligan. He's 0-1 thus far. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. And this one's downstairs. It's a ball and a strike. Wing and a miss on the cut fastball, 1-2.
Hey, what, I'm already taking inventory of the fourth inning here, man. The secondary pitch has really been effective. He's used it well. It's getting a lot of good results. I just wonder if they're going to make an adjustment as the game continues.
On to first, and there were two down.
Eli has
first pitch of the at bat on its way.
Man, I tell you what, I love how he's pitching right now. He has continued to pound that first pitch with strikes. When you do that, you set yourself up for great success.
I don't know what would have been more right there.
Here comes another 0-2. Very weakly on the ground. But that one rolls foul. Bases are empty here with two men.
Side circle change.
Oh. That misses 1-2.
That ball's out of the close. I think he probably tried to throw that out of his own on purpose. Maybe get him to chase and give him something kind of different.
Ball! That pitch is out.
Off everything.
Come on,
he lays off it to even the count 2-2. Now a swing and a hard hit grounder.
Just get him out.
Another 2-2 offering. Pulled the string on him there as this is popped up. Back behind second. McGill got it, and the side is retired. So they go down without a whimper here.
She'll let me get it. I'm going to go for that.
At the plate, Mario Sandoval. 0-1-4 here in this one. And the ball popped foul to the right side, out of play. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Well, they're still in this game. You know, get somebody on a broken bat, a blooper, a bunt, and then you've got to start getting somebody on base. It's obviously needs a base runner and good things happen.
Wind up and the 0-2 pitch. And that was swing and a ball hit in the air out to left field. Mejia sprinting after it. One down. Ready for another chance. Sean Tejada comes in to do that. One ball game. Tejada swinging bunt out in front of the plate.
He's out.
So on to first, takes care of him. Two very quick outs to start the home fifth. Now here's the pitch.
Now batting. First baseman.
Over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. The windup and the 0-1. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two.
Two outs, two strikes, and we're in the fifth inning, and he's got one pitch.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. So a strong start on the mound as he's blanked him through the first five. We're through five here at the ballpark. The Hooks lead it 3-0. Getting in for his second at-bat, Chris Mazo. They look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent today.
No doubt about that. They've been completely overmatched at this point. One hit through five innings. I mean, what else can you say about the pitching they face other than it's been fantastic? We'll see if that continues as we approach the later innings.
Some action out in the bullpen. A couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. This is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. This is popped up, and there's out number two.
Play one game.
Digging in, Terrence Gore. 0-2 with a couple of strikeouts for him so far. Shot quickly to the left. Gonna be a tough play. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. So another good inning. Ready, here's the first
offering.
1-1.
Hawthorne. Second, to start things off as he looks at a ball to start the inning.
1-0. The world has ever seen.
Kick down the third baseline. But a foul ball. 1-1. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Strike two at a pitch that catches the outside corner.
One thing you try to do as a hitter is figure out what pattern the pitcher is pitching. I can't cover the whole plate. He's done a massive job of pounding on the outside half of the strike, and they haven't figured it out yet.
And another foul ball. Again, a 1-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here.
He's just fouling them off to get something he wants to hit.
Swing and he sends the ball high in the air into left field. Mejia racing back and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first down.
I'm getting tired though.
Ready once again, Jason Milligan. 0-2 thus far in this one.
Milligan.
Counts 1-0.
1-0. And a strike to even the count. One and one.
He has full intentions of jamming this guy. Back-to-back cutters right in on the hands. He does not want him to get extended.
Waiting on it is Hernandez. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now.
Number one.
Grounded down the third baseline. This gets foul. It's 0-1. The windup and the 0-1. Chop foul over towards the dugout.
Boy, he's been great this one. He's only one strike away from putting another zero on the scoreboard.
And this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and that'll hold the count at 0-2. Neither guy giving in here, and they'll do it again. Lifted down the line and right and back out of play. Count holds it 0-2. Seared down the first baseline. Perron has it. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Add another zero. Into the windup and Mario Sandoval stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at the ball. It's 1-0. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. Ferrar is over and he's got it for the first out of the inning.
Five outs.
Digging in once again. Tejada, who will not be seen the usual suspect to close this game out as he's been given the day off by his manager to get a little rest.
We were told before the game by the skipper he wanted to avoid using him if possible. So that means they will look to close this thing out without him.
Henry looking at a tough pitch called a strike.
Here
comes the 0-1. Coming to lay off called a strike. Looking to punch him out again. Pitch. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Two out, nobody on. Got him.
Zero.
So he's down on strikes for the second time here tonight. He's through eight with the shutout intact. And tonight's ends as a 3-0 shutout win. The Corpus Christi Hooks earn the victory despite only collecting four total hits. Eli Manning earns his first win of the season, allowing only a single hit across eight full innings. Randall Watts was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. Rob Allsweed records the save, his first of the year. So that's a wrap here tonight. For my partners in the booth, Harold Reynolds and Dan Plezak, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vesper.
72 strikes, 11 balls, one hit, no base slips, zero balls, 5 strikeouts. Oh, that was good. I'm not sure any points for that. Rangers. On the Astros. This guy's at 87. Greatest pitcher ever lived. Nice strike. becomes the best. He's the best era on the team. Zero. They're nine. Oh god. Me and this guy. That's what I don't get talking about. See you next time on MLB Rhythm Show, Eli Manning. For now, I'll see you. Goodbye.